angels, and prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. There is no other place found any more in heaven. 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent, called the devil, and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
10. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accuseth them before our God day and night. Verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they loved not their life unto the death. Amen.
Yes.
Father, bless the reading of your word.
Yes.
Let your word come with power. Let your word come with conviction. Let your word heal every heart. Let your word break every yoke. Let your word release every soul that is under captivity. Let demons flee by the hearing of your word. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Can I hear amen to that? Can I hear amen to that? On a brief topic which I title The Blood of the Lamb and the Words of Their Testimony. Say with me, the blood of the Lamb. Say it one more time. Please shout it out of your voice. The blood of the Lamb and the words of their testimony. The Bible said, listen carefully, that there was war in heaven. The Bible did not tell us what prompted the war, but one thing we know is that Satan had access to heaven. And because God does not want him again in heaven, God sent his angels to push him down. And the angels of God fought with Satan and his angels. And the Bible said they had no place in heaven. Now, the Bible explained to us the weapon in which they use to defeat Satan in verse 11. Are you hearing what I'm saying? They did not just use only sword. I know they may use sword, but they did not just use only sword. There are two powerful weapons. Somebody say powerful weapon. Can you agree with me? It's a powerful weapon. There are two powerful weapons that the angels have to use to defeat Satan. That is the two weapons I want to talk about this hour. The first weapon is the blood of the Lamb. Who is the Lamb? The Bible tells us that John the Baptist saw Jesus and he said, this is the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of men. So Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God. Jesus Christ is also the high priest. In the Old Testament, before a man's sin can be covered, the priest ought to kill a lamb at the holiest of holies, and they use the blood to sprinkle, and God, with the sin of man, will be covered. They do it regularly, once, probably once a year. But this has been something that they have been doing, and it has no powerful effect. Why did I say it has no powerful effect? Because the sin was covered. The sin was not cleansed. It's just like when you use a pen to write on a paper and you use the eraser. Most times, some erasers don't remove the pen. If you use pencil to write on the paper, the eraser can the stair. What a man sees is like using pen on the paper and using eraser. It cannot remove it. Now, there is a white color. I don't know. There is a white something they use to cover the ink. If you can agree with me,
yes.
They cover it so that the ink will be beneath the white ink, and you can write on top. That is exactly what they were doing in the Old Testament. But Jesus Christ brought a solution for mankind. The solution that can clean the ink on the paper, and there will never be a trace. That is why the Bible says, when God forgive your sin, he remember it no more. Amen. Now, I'm trying to explain to you what I mean by the blood of the Lamb. The blood of Jesus was shed on the cross of Calvary. Why? So that our sin will not only be forgiven, but also be wiped away. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. The Bible said, all things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. You never have yesterday if you are washed by the blood of Jesus. I repeat it again. You never have yesterday if you are washed by the blood of Jesus. God washed your yesterday, and he starts a new beginning with you. He brings out a new fire with you. I prophesy to somebody here, God will cleanse you today. Whatsoever stain in your life shall be washed by the blood of Jesus. Can I hear louder? Amen. By the blood of Jesus, there is other thing the blood also do. The blood is a powerful weapon to attack or to defeat the devil. The blood is a powerful weapon to defeat the devil. Why did I say so? Listen, there is no other blood that can be able to deliver mankind. Can you hear what I'm saying? Please, I want you to be quiet. Let this place be quiet. There is no other blood that can be able to deliver mankind. No blood. You remember when God, said, Abraham, use Isaac, your son, for sacrifice. And Isaac was that a sinner. The Bible said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There is no righteous, not even one. And when Abraham lifted up his dagger to sacrifice his son, God said, no, Abraham, I prefer this lamb to use for sacrifice. The lamb that was prepared was a type of Jesus Christ. It was trying to tell you that there will be a substitute for every sacrifice. And the lamb was used for the sacrifice. When Jesus Christ appeared, when Jesus Christ was born, he ought to be the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Now, I want to give you some secret. One of my secret about the blood of Jesus Christ is that in the blood of Jesus, there is no sin. I repeat it again. In the blood of Jesus, there is no sin. In every man's blood, there is attachment of Adamic nature. There is the flow of the DNA of Adam in our blood, whether you like it or not. Insofar as the Bible says, Adam and Eve were the first man that came on this planet Earth. I want you to understand that every man that is born on this planet Earth has Adam DNA. Now, Jesus Christ was called the last Adam. Why was he called the last Adam? He was God that was made flesh. Everything about Jesus, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, is the word of God. And the Bible said in John chapter 1 verse 14, the word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and full of truth. Now, I want you to sound. Listen to me. The reason why Satan cannot be able to withstand the blood of Jesus. Number one, there is no sin in the life of Jesus. When Jesus Christ was on earth, he did not commit sin. When Jesus Christ was on earth, he was the Word of God, the incarnation of God. He was the incarnated Word of God that put on flesh. His flesh did not come from Mary. Rather, Jesus Christ, his flesh came from the Word of God. His blood came from the Word of God. His spirit came from the Word of God. Everything about Jesus is called the Word of God. He was the living Logos. He was the Word that became flesh. He was the Word that was manifested in the form of a woman. Listen to me. Jesus was God that put on flesh. According to Timothy, the Bible said, great is the mystery of godliness. He said what? God put on flesh. God put on flesh. What am I trying to tell you this? For the first time, God had to produce blood. Listen, God had to produce blood. What we are talking about is the blood of the Son of God. Is the blood of the Word of God. Is the blood that carried the DNA of God. Is the blood that carried the power of God. Is the blood that carried the life of God. Do you know in the book of Leviticus? Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11. The Bible said that in every creature, the life in every creature is the blood. If you are losing blood in the hospital, they will run to give you blood, because whenever you have shortage of blood, there is a tendency that you are going to die, because it is the blood that sustains your life. When there is no blood in you, definitely you must surely die. Now, what did Jesus did? When Jesus lived on earth, he lived as God man on earth, and he had to have a blood never been defined by sin. He had to have a blood that is so pure. The Bible said the blood speaks better things than the blood of Abel. The blood of Abel was speaking judgment, but the blood of Jesus is speaking for mercy. Now we are talking about the blood of God, the blood that carried the life of God. So if the Bible said in Leviticus that there is life in every blood, is to tell you that the life of Christ was in his blood. Who is Jesus Christ? Jesus Christ is the Word of God. The life in the world was in his blood. The life and the power in God was in his blood. Everything about the power of Jesus, the power that Jesus Christ possessed, was in his DNA. If you go to the hospital, if they want to know what is wrong with you, where you came from, and they will quickly come to your DNA. They can quickly tell you where you originated from. When they took the DNA of Jesus, not recently, they could dig out the Ark of the Covenant that the children of Israel had. They handled. They could dig it out. Listen, they went to do some sample, and they saw the blood of Jesus Christ on that ark. Listen, where Jesus Christ were being crucified, it was on top of the ark. And when there was earthquake, the Bible said in the book of Matthew that there was an earthquake, and the blood of Jesus dropped on the ground and located the ark and plead for mercy. And when they found the ark, they did the DNA of the blood that was on top of the ark. They found out that it was the blood of a woman. You know, there are two people that are responsible for DNA. You know, in your DNA, your father and your mother. They found out that it was only the DNA of Mary that was found. God does not have the DNA. What am I trying to tell you? Jesus Christ did not come from the earth. Jesus Christ came from heaven. When he told the people, he said, I came down from heaven. I want you to know the power. I want you to know what it takes when you shout the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is trying to tell you that there is power in that the power of God, the life of God is invested in the blood of Jesus. So when the angels in heaven were saying they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, they were trying to explain to you that there is no other blood you can use to overcome Satan. There is no other blood that carries the power in the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is the highest blood you can talk about. Can I hear amen to that? If you kill a ram and pour it on a stone, you activate that stone to react. The reason why some charms are more effective than others is because we have stages of blood. If you kill a goat and if you kill a cow, a goat blood and a cow blood are not the same. If you kill a woman, the blood of a woman is not the same with the blood of a goat. There are varieties, and that is how the power and the potency in the blood are. What am I trying to explain this to you? The blood of Jesus is the highest blood you can be able to rely on. The blood of Jesus carries life of God. The blood of Jesus carries the potency of God. He carries the spirit of God. When you call that blood, the power of God, the life of God, the spirit of God will appear. Can I hear amen to that?
Yeah.
And the Bible said they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Today I prophesy, any blood, any demon, any Satan that is speaking against your life, we overcome them by the blood of Jesus. Can you say the blood of Jesus? Can you say the blood of Jesus? Can you say the blood of Jesus? Do you know what the blood of Jesus is? Listen, it takes only the blood of Jesus to buy humanity. Humanity was sold to Satan by Adam. And the only thing that can buy humanity, the only thing that can buy this whole world, is not dollar, it's not euro. Satan said to Jesus, I will give you this world if you bow to me. And when Jesus Christ shed his blood, listen to me, there are several places where he shed his blood. The Bible recorded that he came out from the grave and he said, in heaven and on earth has been given to me. That means I have this word in my power. I am now called the controller. I am now the general controller of this world. How was he the controller? Because he bought the world by his blood. Can I quickly tell you? If you go to adopt a child, you must pay some ransom. Jesus presented his blood to adopt you from Satan, to adopt you from the world. Jesus, he paid the price of his blood. So when the angels were saying, I overcome you, Satan, I overcome you, Satan, Satan, you know, had no option, because the blood of Jesus was the highest price that had ever been paid by mankind. The blood of Jesus was the highest price that has ever been paid by mankind. Can you shout the blood of Jesus? Can you shout the blood of Jesus? This is the reason why, you know, when they are attacking you, when you shout the blood of Jesus, Satan has no other excuse than to flee. The blood is so powerful that Satan cannot argue with you. Because the blood carries the life of God. The blood carries the power of God. The blood is infused with the word of God. It is the word that produces the blood. Am I communicating to somebody here? And I want to quickly talk about the second one, which I call the testimony. They overcame it by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. What have you been saying matters whether you can defeat Satan or not. If you are saying negative things to your destiny, You can't win. You can't win this battle. See, the battle we fight is the battle of the spirit. It's not a physical battle. Jesus, the Bible said the weapon of our warfare are not carnal. And the Bible said we are not fighting against flesh and blood. Hallelujah. When Goliath came to David with a long spear and his sword, David said, "You came, you are coming to me with this spear and sword, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, of the Israelite in whom you have defied." In the name of the Lord of hosts, it is a spiritual battle. What you say concerning your life determines whether you can win that battle or whether you can lose it. Whenever we are talking about the words of his testimony, I want to divide it into different parts. Number one, what you say from your mouth is the word of your testimony. What you say concerning that situation, if you say, "I don't die, oh, that situation will kill you," that is the testimony you are giving. If you are a gossip, I'm very sorry for you, because you end up in a negative way, because you always say negative testimonies. So what you say concerning your situation matters. But I see the angels of God that were saying, "Your place has entered in this heaven. You must go down. Your place has entered in this heaven." The Bible says an accuser of brethren, no more will you accuse the brethren. That is the first kind of testimony. The second kind of testimony is what you preach. What you preach. Listen to me, Jesus Christ was talking about his testimony. What are you preaching to others is the testimony that you give. What testimony do you hear concerning this gospel? If you tell people that this gospel can save them, this gospel will save you. If you tell people that this gospel can heal you, truly there is power that in this gospel can heal you. This is the book of the testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the testimony you ought to preach. Preach this word day and night. That is when you can overcome Satan. Preach this word wherever you go. That is when you can defeat your enemy. Then another part of the testimony is that there are things you ought to, there are some revelation you ought to bring from this scripture, and you hold them so strong. When the devil is trying to tell you, you can't do it. You let the devil know, the book of the testimony says, "I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me." Can I hear hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
When they're telling you, "No, you cannot be a child anymore, you are too old," you will tell them from the book of our testimony. You will tell them, "Even in old age, I can still bear fruit," says the book of testimony. Is the book of testimony. You cannot defeat Satan without this book of testimony. Understand what the book of testimony is talking about and use it to defeat Satan. Look at Jesus Christ when Satan came to him 3 times. You know, Jesus was trying to, and Satan was trying to quote the book of testimony. I'm talking about the Old Testament. And Jesus Christ 3 times quoted the book of testimony. Somebody said the book of testimony. Do you know what Jesus says? "I have come to do all that is written about me." There is something written about you here. We call this the book of testimony. If you are a child of God and you don't know what the book of testimony is talking about, you are disadvantaged. God wants you to understand, before you can overcome Satan, you will overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of your testimony. Another kind of testimony that puts Satan into madness is when you come out with your microphone. Now let me give you, for instance, imagine that there are people that hate you here. There are people that does not want you to succeed. Imagine that. You know, the Bible said, in the presence of my enemy, he anoints my head with oil, and my cup run over. Imagine you have enemies, and you come and pick them up. You say, Pastor, I want to give a testimony. You say, praise the Lord. And everybody say, hallelujah. And you say, last week, somebody just put in 20,000 euro into my account. Praise the Lord. And it is not only that. You say, I got a new job. Praise the Lord. And you say, it is not only that. You know, I have now a brand new car. Praise the Lord. Your enemy will be defeated by your testimony. Do you get what I'm talking to you? I'm saying right now. Listen, listen to me. Listen to me. The problem we are having is that we want to please everybody. You cannot please everybody. There are people that want you to always cry. There are people that when they want to see you, that when you are walking as somebody that has been defeated. The only way you can defeat your enemy, whenever you eat or you do not eat, feel happy. Whenever you eat or you didn't eat, give a testimony. Come out and share what God has done for you. Your enemies shall be put to shame. He is afraid of testimony. For instance, they gossip you. See her. She can never give birth. She is barren. She can never give birth. And a month came, you were walking like this. They said, why is she walking like that? What is happening? This thing is giving you testimony. 2 months, you are still walking like this. They said, the beginning will come out. Now, so he come out the other time. 3 months, you are still walking like this. 4 months, you are still walking like this. Your pregnancy is waiting for you. Can I hear hallelujah? And those that gossip you say, hey, are you sick? What is happening to you? You will tell them, it's like something is in this belly. You tell them it's like God has visited me. Any man that does not want to see you, rejoice. Your testimony will put them to shame. 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 See, I learned something recently. Don't argue with people. When they say you are this, you are that. Say, Father, speak for me. Let my testimony speak for me. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When God gives you testimony, he will close the mouth of your enemies. When God gives you testimony, those that gossip you will try to pretend to be your friend. When God gives you testimony, Pastor Miracle, do you know your son is a testimony? Madam, do you know your son is a testimony? You know, when you are pregnant, they'll say, what do you want born? You want born again? Oh, who am I talking to this morning? Any man or woman that say you will not prosper, any man or woman that say you will not make it, may God shut their mouth. 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 You might be that so wicked that they just want to hear your bad news. They are so wicked that when something bad happens to you, that is when they rejoice. But whenever something good is coming to you, they will find a way to spoil it. Listen, this is your year. I said, this is your year. She was ashamed. One woman carried pregnancy. So she went to her say. Those that have mocked me, your husband has been a priest, has been praying for people, and things have been working for them. You that is pastor wife, nothing is working for you. And when Elizabeth got pregnant, the Bible says she went to hide 5 months. Why did she hide? I will tell you. You see, whenever God wants to embarrass your enemy, he makes your miracle to be right. Do you understand what I mean? Imagine somebody that they say is barren, and after 5 months they were looking for her. Not one. They said, maybe don't go to Jerusalem. Maybe don't go out of shame. How can she bear it? A pastor wife, a priest wife, you don't have a child. Maybe don't run out of the community. Those that were gossiping her were saying, what is happening? 4 months, 5 months, the fifth month, she came out like this. When she came out, I suspect, shall we say she don't qualify blood? She said she don't qualify blood. This one not be beginning of 5 months. How can a woman of her age say she's pregnant? No, it will be 5 months. Can I talk to somebody? Your enemy shall be confused.
She came before the altar of God. She wanted to pray. Her heart
get married. Because she has gotten a child, she thought you will not get your child. In the presence of your enemy, God will anoint your head. In the presence of your enemy, your cup shall run over. In the presence of your enemy, God will fulfill your heart desire. The first day Hannah became pregnant. How many of you have ever imagined someone that is looking for a child and got sick? Sister, when you got sick that first time, you thought it was malaria. You thought it was malaria. You see, sometimes, if God wants to give you a miracle, you will not understand how the miracle comes about. He's going to tell you it's not by power. It's not by might, but by the Spirit of God. Let me quickly tell you what God had for Hannah before I ran off. My time is already up. You see, in Israel, God is looking for the metal prophet. And everybody God give a child, that woman will say, no, not my child, no, not my child. No, my child no go serve God. And God was so tired of this. And he was waiting for somebody to die in the realm of the spirit and say, God, I will give you a prophet. Give me a son. I will give you a prophet. If you can give me a son, I will give you a prophet. I want you to understand, by that time, all the priests and all the prophets have offended God. God was not in good terms with them anymore. The Bible said the vision was no more existing at that period. For a long time, God had never revealed himself to any prophet in vision because of the sin which they commit. And God was saying, who will give me a prophet? And the woman said, Lord, give me a son, and I shall give you a prophet. God said, that is it. That is it. That is it. I got her. I got her. I got her. 1 month that came, and the Bible said, and the Lord remembered Hannah. God will remember you. God will remember you. Pastor, when I asked God this question, and God remembered Hannah, I put, so God, all this while you forgot Hannah. Can I talk to someone? Not that God does not know you exist, but the day God decides to remember your case, that is the day that problem is solved. The file of Hannah has been in the presence of God. All her prayer requests have been done. And God, whenever they bring the letter of Hannah, God will give it. They bring it, God will give it. This God was still saying, I need a prophet. They bring it, God will give it. Until Hannah said, give me a son, and I shall give you a prophet. God said, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hannah, okay, your letters have been here. Now you have contact. You know what I need. Your letter has been piling here. There are people that their prayers have been piling before the presence of God. Not because God is not seeing it, but because it has not been connected to what God needs. And today I come to activate it. The time Eli prayed, Eli agreed with Hannah and said, Father, remember this woman. According to the time of life, may it be done. As Eli agreed with Hannah, check your Bible, they have been coming to Shiloh. The man of God have never agreed with her. Then we come, sacrifice, and go. There is a power behind agreement prayer. There is a power behind a man of God agreeing with you. Today, I agree with you. God will remember you. God will remember you. God will remember you. God will remember you. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. I want to just agree with certain people before we share the grace. Listen, I don't know what you are going through. You just need an agreement by a man of God. Eli had been coming to Shiloh, sacrifice and go, cry and go. It was your, sometimes your prayer will not be heard by your crying. Sometimes it takes an agreement prayer for that prayer to be answered. There are stubborn problems that need special attention. Jesus says, this kind cannot go out. So there is a kind of problem that needs special attention. Today, I prophesy to somebody. As many that will say amen to this prayer, I prophesy to you that the God in whom we serve in Messiah ministry will remember your case. 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 Worship the name of Jesus Christ. Worship the name of Jesus.
Church, if you are too familiar with your pastor, you miss it. Other
yesterday I was praying for someone. I will continue. I was praying for someone. God opened my eyes in the realm of the spirit. I saw a well. And I asked the sister, "Sister, I'm seeing a well. What do you have to do with a well?" And the sister told me, "I drank the same drink 3 days ago. I also saw a well. And they want to push me inside that well." And I pray for how many of you saw it online? You saw it online. God bless you. Listen, this sister, I'm trying to tell you, September she's going for our final coronation and marriage. And she said, "Man of God, you must come with me. So I will lodge you on a powerful hotel." You don't understand what I'm saying. I come to prophesy for somebody here. If somebody in Ireland can be blessed, I decree by the power of God.
Lift up your seat.
Father, I bless this seat.